There's so many thoughts that we say that are wasting us money. Did you know that? Well, today we're gonna dive into a couple thoughts that we think on the daily that are wasting us money, and I'm gonna show you how to start saving. Hey, I'm Lindsay with Organized to Save, and on this channel, I'm here to help you get organized, be more productive, and save you some moolah. And today, we're gonna be talking about some thoughts that you are constantly thinking to yourself that are just draining your bank accounts. So you might be thinking to yourself, what could I be thinking that's wasting me money? Negativity is gonna kill your action. What I'm talking about is all of the negative thoughts that we think about ourselves, about what we can do. All of those things are holding us back from taking action and actually being able to accomplish those things. So before we dive into some of these thoughts that are wasting your money, a quick little activity that you can do is to actually write them down. Journal them out, and then once you have them written down, look at them and tell yourself, is this actually something that I want to be thinking? Is this something that I want to be continually telling myself on the daily? Or is it something that you need to flush away? Something that I have done in the past is write down negative thoughts that I thought about myself and then turn them into positives. Let's go ahead and dive into these thoughts that are stealing your money. The first one is a super simple one, but it's a thought, oh, it's only $10. What's $10? How many times have you gone to the mothership, AKA Target, and found something that was super adorable and it was only $10? Come on, it's only $10. And then you get to the checkout and you realize that you threw in several only $10 items, realizing that your bill is a lot higher than $10. So be mindful of those little purchases that you might think don't mean a thing. In reality, they stack up and they could be big money if you actually use them properly. Instead of doing that unconscious spending, actually think about every purchase that you're making. Number two, YOLO! You only live once, so why not blow all my money on a super expensive vacation and put it on my credit card? Yeah, no. You do only live once, so you want to live your life with intention. And racking up a bunch of credit card debt, that's not gonna do it for you. So be intentional with your money. If you want to go on a vacation, save up for it. Because going on that fancy vacation is gonna be amazing, but if you put it on a credit card, you're gonna have to come home to the reality. And if instead you paid for it in cash, coming home is gonna be that much sweeter. So don't give up the YOLOs in life, but instead think of them with intention and purpose and save for them. Number three, I've got plenty of time to save. I wanna give you a little example. If you know that you want to be a millionaire by the time that you are 65, but you don't start saving until you're 50 years old, you're gonna need to save over $40,000 a year in order to meet that goal. If you were to start saving at 20 instead of 50, you'd only have to save about $4,500 a year instead of $40,000 a year. Think about that. How would that impact your paycheck each year? So think about your goals and how you're gonna get there and start saving now. No matter what age you are, you are better off starting now than waiting till later to save. So the next you might be thinking, well, I don't make enough to save. Well, I would like to encourage you to just start saving a little bit now, because even if you're just throwing aside a couple dollars each paycheck, you're gonna be in a better off place if you start saving now rather than waiting until later, because now you can put in money into a savings account. If you get one that you get interest, bonus points, you're gonna be in a much better place in order to reach your goals. So start now, no matter what stage of life you're in, no matter how old you are, establish your goals first and then start making strides in order to meet those goals by setting aside a little bit each month. Thought number five is, I am too far in debt. There's just no point in even trying to get out. If you are stressing out with a mound of debt, believe me, I know that feeling. We have been there. When my husband and I got married, we had over $100,000 in debt between the two of us. And what a weight that is to carry. The thing that helped us get out was to change the way we thought about it. So right now you might be thinking, okay, I have $100,000 worth of debt. I have no idea how I'm gonna pay that off. Well, I want you to change the form of the way that you are thinking. So instead of thinking about that huge number that you have, now obviously it's good to know what that number is because you need to know what you're trying to do. So for example, you're not gonna come in on Monday morning expecting to accomplish a 40-hour work week within 1 8-hour day. No, you're gonna break that up into manageable things that you can tackle each day of the week. So I want you to do the same thing with your debt. I want you to look at it and break it down and set goals for yourself. Pick one loan. Maybe you pick your lowest loan so that way you can quickly pay it off. So break it down. Don't just focus on the huge number that you have to pay off. Break it down and focus on taking it one step at a time, paying off one bill at a time, and think of how satisfying that's gonna be once you are able to actually start checking those off your list. Bonus tip for you, keep track of those debt payoffs. I have a freebie that you can download. I'll leave it linked down below, but it's a family budget worksheet that's gonna help you not only actually work through your budget, but there's a specific spot in it where you can track your goals that you're achieving. So if you make an extra payment on one of your debts, write it down. Keep track of your achievements because that's gonna help keep you motivated as you are seeing the great things that you are doing. So stop talking negative to yourself, change your form of thinking, and start thinking positive about the great things that you can do with your finances. If you're wanting to dive deeper into budgeting, I will leave a playlist linked above so you can check it out. And until then, we'll see you in the next video.